That's Frank. Today we're going to be talking about coaching and mentoring for our group project. The objective of the presentation is basically on the three parts. You understand the difference between the coaching and the mentoring. To understand why the coaching is useful in the working. And to use the coaching and mentoring skills in the practice in our group project. First of all, the aims of the coaching and the mentoring is the process of the whole group have identified issues, solve the problems, and commit the action. Okay? For the individuals, we devote for the skills, motivation, self-symptoms, and confidence. For the last part, I will be explaining in our group work. Coaching related to the primary really to performance improvement in the specific skills areas. The goals are typically set with or the suggestion of the coach. While the learners has the primary ownership of the goal, and the coach has the primary ownership of the process. Coaching is health skills, which is advice is not given from the coach. It is a non-directive and non-judgmental advice. We are all focused on the solutions, and because the promise a high degree of the independence for each one, and also use the skills of the questioning, clarifying, reflecting, observing, and giving the feedback from each other. Mentoring relates primarily to the identification and the nurturing of the potential for the whole person. It can be a long-term relationship where the goals may change but are always set by the learners. The learners on the both of the goals and the process is different between the coaching. The mentor has expert knowledge or the experience who can give the real answers for the learners. It is the specific and directions advice given. Also, we are focused on the solutions and commit the teacher students specific the action. Mentoring versus the coaching. First of all, the mentoring is not coaching. Because the mentoring is reserved for your most talent partners. And a mentor is usually a long term between each other. That is the mentoring relationships shortens your partners, the learnings, covers and increase the productivity. Coaching is impartial, focused on the improvements in the behaviors. You cannot motivate another person, but you can practice the situations which will enhance them and encourage them to motivate themselves. So the reason to use the coaching, because the organization's success depends on developing and the coaching is a key factors for organization in attracting and retaining the best employees. Employees are inspired to the work to their greatest potentials when they are given support and encouraged to develop their skills. So it is prepare both the employees and the organization for the future. The practice for our group work is there are five MSc marketing students build a group who are a British, a Norwegian, and three Chinese. Coaching and mentoring are all necessary in order to achieve the goals of the teamwork. In addition to obtain the mentoring from my teams, and also Daniel as the team leaders, who is the coaching with other members to solve the problems and commit the actions, such as the language barriers from the Chinese students and distributions of the tasks and setting meetings. So I'm here. I use four FLOW models for the coaching. It's like, firstly, we need to find the challenge from each other in the group. We need to look at the reality, like the locations, like the education, like the cultures difference. We need to open the possibilities. We need to open for each other to have a deeply to communications and win the commitment. As you see, using of the coaching, firstly, we build the trust. We introduce for each other and use the social networking to communications. Also, we have the after-school activities, meetings or parties, have dinner, something else. And depend on coaching skills, the solutions to each person's professional challenges are to be found. And we all have updated the potential to learn and to improve what we do. We share the own skills as a culture for each other, and we improve what we do for the next in the group work. And the limits to achieve all the potentials are largely self-imposed. And that's it. Thank you very much. Here's my reference.